Hello, Astronaut Randy Bresnik. I'm here to talk to you about Puffy-Head Bird-Legs, because that's what happens to us when we get to orbit. All the fluid that's in our body can now go wherever it needs to, and it's the same pressure. Because right now, I've got all this water in my legs that's keeping it so I have enough water in my head so I don't pass out. Well, it turns out that when you get to space, that extra gallon and a half of water that's there to counteract gravity floats up and makes your head really, really puffy, really uncomfortable. So if you kind of like hung upside down for about a half an hour here in gravity, that'd be about how your head feels. And so until you get past the, you know, day and a half mark up in space where you can urinate out that extra gallon and a half, it's pretty, you know, pretty stuffy and puffy head. All right, now over to Marty and Beth to learn more.
Thanks, comrade. Let's talk a little bit about Puffy-Head Bird-Legs.
I'd like to introduce you to a friend of mine. This is astronaut Glovey McGloverson. As you can see, he's filled with fluid, and that fluid right now is down here in his feet.
If you've ever stood on your feet for a long time, you'll notice they'll swell up. That's because the fluid is making its way down to your feet.
Now let's see what happens when we flip him upside down. All of that fluid rushes down to his head and you know, leaves the foot region. And, you know, if you were doing that, it would feel like you kind of had a stuffy head.
Now, this happens to astronauts when they go into space. This fluid is not pulled down by gravity, so it sort of floats around. It gets up into your head, and you get a puffy head and little bird legs.
If you want to try this in your classroom, head over to our website and check out the lesson plan.